neither he nor she. It can't be found, but it's all around, quite close to you and me. Magic Mouse, Magic Mouse, it's the one thing that I think of every day. Oh, Magic Mouse, Magic, Magic Mouse, won't you please come to my home with me and stay? Twinkle in an eye or a smile upon a face, you'll know that the magic mouse has come and left some happiness in its place. And when you find a penny on the street, you'll know that it's been there. For the magic mouse leaves signs about as it travels through the air. Magic mouse,
Angelville and Magic Mouse. My name's Cocky Boo, B-O-O, Cocky Boo. And this is my friend, Mabel Muldoon. And today, I got a secret for you. Elwood and I have found somebody. Right, Elwood? Ernie Coleman.
Wow, I like Ernie Coleman, yeah.
He's 82 years old.
He's older than me, even older than my tree.
Yeah, and he's a jazz musician. Jazz, you ever hear of jazz?
I don't know what's a jazz.
Well, they play the kind of music that your grandma and grandpa used to dance to.
Wow.
So would you like to learn about grandma and grandpa's music?
Yes, I would. Yes, I would. Yes, I would.
Well, let's go dancing with Ernie Coleman and his trio.
Let's do it.
Thank you. from different mothers, and likewise different fathers. Like us, there are no others. We're brothers just the same. Hey!
I like to eat zucchini,
but we prefer linguine.
Last night we had string beanie.
We're brothers just the same.
Go and get it.
I'm going to get it.
Okay. All set, Jessup?
I'm ready.
Okay. Okay. Ding-a-ling-a-ling.
Let my people go.
Let me have it.
What?
Let me have it.
Sure. You...
The Adventures of Buck McKee, or Buck Triathlete. What courage, what strength, what teeth.
What courage? Who what strength? Who what teeth?
You're gonna be on the team. Yeah. We're gonna play baseball.
That's right.
You should know the fella's name.
Yeah, sure.
Well, then who's on first?
That's right.
The fella's name.
Who?
The guy's name.
Who?
The man's name.
Who?
The first baseman.
Who's on first?
I'm asking you who's on
That's
first.
The man's
That's
name.
Whose name?
That's right.
Go ahead and tell me.
That's it.
There's no funny, sir. But you never seen someone eat an apple before?
What's the same day for skiddy? Ask a singer, bing, bang, bing, bang, 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 ask a singer, bing, bang, bang, bang.
Come on, Buck, you can do it. Buck, try out the spoof. Whoops. When a runner hits the wall, it's deadly, be assured. And Buck is hit and can be saved by just one single word.
Today we have got a special treat for you. We've got a, well, I don't know what to call him. I guess he's a clown. He's a potato peeler. That's all he is. I know his name is Wolf, but he's late. And Wolf, where are you? I mean, you're supposed to have been here. The show has started, and you're not here, and the kids are all here. And oh gosh, man, I wish you'd come on time. You're always late. You angry at him for being late? He kept you waiting and all the children? Well, Mabel, you did such a horrible thing. I think I'm going to leave you to your own. If you get Mabel mad at you like you did, well, I don't know. Mouse and I are going to take Mabel and go rest. You figure it out. I'm not going to, well, I'll forgive you, but you're on your own.
son dos mujeres lindas. Ahí donde yo de que me lo aprendí.
Time for a story about the magic mouse. As you know that, well, maybe you don't, but it all started a long, long time ago. It was in a faraway place, close to the hearts of those knowing love, and there was a village called Angelville. Now, if you were going too fast or happened to sneeze, you wouldn't see it. No, you wouldn't. Angelville was just a tiny speck of a place, a desert oasis with simple wooden and adobe houses and dirt roads. But the light which shone from Angelville, well, it was so strong, it could be seen as far away as the farthest star. And the light could be seen, oh, it was like the sparkle tips of the heavens. It was so magnificent. And the only way you could get to Angelville was to find the secret path which led to the center of everything. Now, some people say that this path was created by a tiny, oh, so tiny glob of beautiful, gentle energy which lived high, high, high up in the heavens above Angelville. It had no shape nor any form. It was just it. Yet, wherever it went, it brought love, peace, happiness, harmony, and understanding. Then one day, from that faraway place, there came a cry for help. It was from all of the children of Angelville who had gathered in a circle and looked up to the heavens and said, "Please, whoever you are, whatever you are, will you come to our village? Will you come to Angelville so that we may better understand the light of your love?" "Why, of course I'll come. What should I look like? Should I look like you, or you, or you, or who?" "We don't know," the children said. "Does it make any difference? Just come." "All right then, let me think." I know, I'll come as a large, gigantic bird-like creature, so large as to frighten all beings into doing what I want. Just "Oh, no," the children said. "You can't get what you want by frightening people. If you want someone to do something, you must be loving and caring and sharing. Don't be large and mean," they said. "Be small. Be so tiny that no one will ever, ever see you. They'll only feel you. Be a mouse. Be a magic mouse. And in the snapping of a finger and the twinkling of an eye, Magic Mouse arrived in Angelville. But the children had made a horrid mistake. They had asked Mouse to be so small so as never ever to be seen. And no one could tell if Mouse were a boy or a girl. Mouse said, "It makes no difference." "Then how can we tell you're about?" Mouse said, "I shall leave pennies about. If ever you find a penny and you pick it up and you press it to your head and the penny stays, you'll know that Magic Mouse has left it. And with this penny, you can take it at night and put it under your pillow. And in the morning, when you awaken, the penny will still be there. But what will be gone will be all your frightening and scary dreams, and they may not return unless you allow them. So if you have a Magic Mouse penny, and you don't allow a frightening and scary dream, you'll be protected." Well, the children were so excited, they rushed about the village shouting, "Magic Mouse is here! Magic Mouse is here! Our troubles are over! Our troubles are over! Magic Mouse is here!" And Mouse just looked at them and smiled and said, "Perhaps when they understand that sunshine has nothing to do with the weather." But the children wanted to have a party to celebrate the arrival of Magic Mouse. "It's too late," said Mother Amal. "Have your party tomorrow." Well, it's not every day a Magic Mouse comes." But Mother Amal was adamant. She was firm. She would not give in. And that's our story for today. Tune in tomorrow and find out if they had their time stop party. Thank you.
This is Lester Quibbles with my quibble for the day. My quibble for the day is homework. Yes, homework. We all know homework is stupid. Stupid and stupider. Homework takes up so much time when you could be doing other things. What other things, you ask? Rolling around on the floor with your dog, sleeping, eating, all of those other stupid things you could be doing. Might as well do homework, right? Yes, you might as well do homework, and I'll tell you why. Because if you don't, your mom will get mad, your teacher will get mad, the principal will get mad, your father will get mad, the dog will get mad. So you'd better do your homework. Yes, homework. Homework is something that's stupid. Why do work at home? Why not do it at school? School, school. That's stupid in itself, but I'll tell you, you have to go to school, you have to do that work, and you have to do more than you do at school. So where are you going to do it? In the laundry? No. Where are you going to do it? On the bus? No. Where are you going to do it? On the baseball diamond? No. You're going to do it at home. And that's why you have to do homework, even though it is stupid. And this is Lester Quibbles with my quibble for the day.
That there's no more, but I know this ain't true. 'Cause I push far beyond, now what my body could do. Yes, I live inside a body, it's made of clay. I must have chose to live like this somewhere along the way. 'Cause at times I'm free from the rocky soil I sow, and in between I get along just what I know. Yes, it's more than just flesh and guts, more than skin and bone. The spirit is the gift, and the body is the home. Yes, it's more than just flesh and guts. Thoughts in which I live, I hope to see tomorrow, and now somehow try to give. Yes, it's more than just flesh and guts, more than skin and bone. The spirit is the gift, and the body is the home. Yes, it's more than just flesh and guts, more than skin and bone. The body is the more than
Yes, ma'am.
Have you finished folding the sock?
Yes, ma'am.
What about that one?
What one?
The one behind your back.
Oh, ma, one sock always gets lost.
Find it.
Ma.
Find it.
What? Did you see something? My sock! Ouch!
Ouch yourself.
Hey, lady.
Who's that?
Get off of us.
Get off of what?
Us, you stupid, stinky feet.
What are you doing here, little girl?
Yeah, what are you doing here?
I'm looking for my lost sock.
How do you know it's lost?
Yeah, how do you know you're not lost?
I'm not lost. I know exactly where I am.
Oh, yeah? Where?
Where am I?
You are in the Commonwealth of Independent Socks.
Your sock's not lost. He's escaped from stinky feet like yours.
I do not have stinky feet. Well, I'm going to find that sock and bring it home where it belongs. Hey, you!
Ladies and gentlemen, women and men, welcome to...
I'm Right, You're Right.
Now here's your host, Ted Tubesock.
Hello, everybody, and welcome to I'm Right, You're Right, the game with no wrong answers. Let's meet our contestants. First, they're Siamese twins, but that doesn't mean they have to look alike. Please welcome Penny and Patty Hose.
Hi, Ted.
Hi, Ted.
Next, he doesn't mind being treated like a baby. That's right, it's Joe Booty.
Hi, Ted.
And finally, straight from the other side of the dryer, it's...
Juliet. What's your name?
Now, have you seen...
Juliet's stinky feet.
That's not my name.
Give them a hand, folks. Now, our first question... Actually, it's our only question, is about colors. What is your favorite color?
Pews.
Chartreuse.
Pews.
Chartreuse.
Pews.
Chartreuse.
Pews.
Chartreuse.
You win.
That's stupid. There were two answers. Anyways, how can you answer a question like that? There is no right answer.
Joe, what's your answer?
How about brand number 10?
Good answer. Now, Juliet's stinky feet.
That's not my name.
Very original answer. You win.
But
you
I win.
In fact, you all win.
That's stupid.
Yeah, isn't it great?
Hey, you, get back here.
Out. Where's my sock?
Free.
But I don't want it to be free. I want it to come home and be folded.
Don't you understand? Your sock's an individual. It doesn't want to be folded. It wants to do what individuals do.
That's stupid.
You keep saying that.
You're late. Now settle down, class. The first question for today is, have you seen this sock? Yes, Patula.
It's on your head.
That's stupid.
Very good, Patula. Okay, how many fingers am I holding up?
You don't have any fingers.
Raise your hands, please. Mortimer.
76.
Yes.
But it's wrong.
Raise your hand. Yes, stinky feet.
Those are the wrong answers, Miss... And that's not my name.
What is your name?
Juliet.
Sorry, that's wrong.
There it is, my sock.
No yelling in class.
That's not a sock. That's Henry. Hi, Henry.
Hey, Henry.
Henry, you're late.
Yeah, leave for Dolly.
No, you're not. You're coming home with me.
Welcome the Independent Sock Hall of Fame. Here on these walls are the images of free socks, the free socks of free individuals.
Oh, please.
Did you have a question?
Yeah, did you see a sock around here?
Why, yes. Here's Abraham Lincoln's sock. Flew off a clothesline in Gettysburg.
No. I mean, did you see a sock like this?
And here's Magic Johnson's sock. See how big it is?
Aha, uh-huh, I got ya.
Help! Help! Stinky Feet, stop!
I'm bringing this sock home where it belongs.
How do you know where it belongs?
It has to come home and be folded.
But I don't want to! I don't want to be like all those other socks, just a copy of someone else. Boo-hoo!
But you have to.
Well, I'm not going.
Ouch! He has to come home.
How come, Stinky Feet?
That's not mine.
I know, that's not your name, so you say. But how can I be sure? And how do you know Henry should go home with you?
Look, I have the mate right here.
Look around you. Look at these hollowed walls. All these socks had mates once. Here are the lost socks of the greatest, who were in a sense lost socks themselves. If these pictures could
Me
talk...
Can.
Oh, yes, I forgot.
I'm Madonna's running sock. She got a hole in the other one, and I was afraid to be thrown out, so I ran.
You see, Juliet, some people, some socks need to rise above the crowd, to be individuals, to live their own lives. We cannot just lie down and be folded.
I understand now.
Hi. Here we are once again, and today we got, hey, look at him. That's Teddy. Teddy got names you wouldn't believe. And he's got a song about after school.
Thank you,
ready?
Cocky Boo.
Yeah, my pleasure.
Got to get an education. Get yourself under control. It's the strangest situation. Can't keep my feet under control. Cause I have dancing in my soul. Oh, now I know my ABCs and one and one and one is three. But check this thing, it's coming down. After school on the playground, big boombox pumping loud. They'll be dancing in the crowd, sweat be running down my face. I'll be jamming around the place, everybody feels the beat. Just can't stop my dancing feet. I give that girl my special look. Just one look was all it took. And out the door, we skip in class. We be gone with no hall pass. And just as I was heading up, the teacher stopped me with a shout. Said, where you going? I act surprised. I tried to think up some good lies. I said, I'm going home today. The teacher said, there ain't no way. And if that's all you got to say, you're staying after school today. And there will be no dancing. After school, he says, there'll be no dancing. After school, he says, there'll be no dancing after school today. Now the principal, he called me in, said, talk to me, I'm your friend. I told him about this dancing thing. He looked at me like I'm insane, said, call the doctor, call the nurse, stop this thing, for it gets worse. Doc said I should take a pill if I can't keep my own feet still. I jumped up, my eyes rolled round. I said, no way you keep me down. I ran out to the playground, a hippin', hoppin', jumpin' sound. A rockin', rappin', dancin' fool, gettin' loose after school. Things was gettin' out of hand. The principal got in the band. The teacher got down on the drum. Everything became undone. The football team began to dance. A crazy circumstance after school. After school today, I say there will be dancing. After school, yes, there will be dancing. After school, yes, there will be dancing. After school today. Now my mother grabbed me by the hair, said, come with me, you're out of there. She put me in my room alone, said, you just wait till Dad gets home. Sister said, I told you so. Mom turned on the radio. I'm feeling bold, I'm feeling proud. I turned the music way up loud. Mom got caught up in the beat. She lost control of her feet. She danced and shimmy, do-si-do, twistling bada-bop limbo. And Daddy walked on in the door. She turned the music up some more. He took one look, he turned around, he said, I'm going back downtown. Started on out towards his car, really didn't get that far. He felt the music in his feet, started dancing in the street. Look out, here we go again, all the neighbors joining in. After school today, I said there will be dancing. After school, there will be dancing. After school, yes, there will be dancing. After school today. There will be dancing after school. Yes, there will be dancing after school. Yes, there will be dancing after school today. Now the mayor called me on the phone, said, you're not in the dancing zone. I said, I know, but I can't stop. The mayor said, I'll call a cop. The cop showed up, he took one look. He threw away his ticket book. And then there came the National Guard, said, stop that dancing in the yard. But they got there a little too late. The dancing swept across the state. The president came on the scene in his presidential limousine. He took one look and jumped right in. And that's the last was seen of him. And when the next election came, everyone wrote in my name. Now I'm president, I'm extra cool. I do the job after school. I said there will be dancing after school. Yes, there will be dancing after school. Yes, there will be dancing after school today. There will be dancing After school, Hester will be dancing. After school, Hester will be dancing. After school today. And now that I'm the president, you get the message that I sent all across the USA. It's time we had a holiday. Everything will be okay. You do some dancing every day. Now hear the presidential rule. There will be dancing after school. After school, I said there will be dancing. After school, there will be dancing. After school, yes, there will be dancing. After school today. I said there will be dancing. After school, there will be dancing. After school, I said there will be dancing. After school today. And yes, there will be dancing. After school, there will be dancing. After school, there will be dancing. After school today. And yet there will be dancing.
I love stories.
Would you like to hear a story
about the
three R's?
Yes.
All right. Well, it all started a long, long time ago. Man didn't know what he was doing. He went out and cut down the trees and burned the wood and made paper and put chemicals in the soil. And he didn't care. He said, so long as when the garbage is here, we can send it over there to someone else's house. And everybody started to collect their garbage. And in the middle of the night, they put it in trucks when nobody was looking. Got that?
Yeah.
And they would go somewhere, and somebody would turn around and say, hey, can we drop it here? Yeah, there's nobody looking. I'll play chicken for the cop. And they dropped the garbage. And in the morning when people woke up, they found there was garbage that showed up in their front lawns.
Yikes.
There was garbage in the streets.
I don't like garbage.
No, but the garbage isn't the responsibility. I mean, garbage is just garbage.
Yes, it is.
But who brought the garbage and dropped the paper out of the car window? And who's the one who didn't care and ate a candy bar and dropped the wrapper on the street?
Yeah.
And who's the person who read a newspaper and when it was done just heaved it over their shoulder?
I did that once.
You did?
Yeah. Well, Dr. C got angry at me.
Dr. C got angry at you?
Yeah, he said, don't litter, don't litter.
Don't litter?
Yeah, that's what he said.
Litter? What litter? I thought a litter is what kittens come in. There's a litter of kittens.
Oh, this
you
is
mean
the,
don't have kittens? I don't understand.
He said it means don't throw your trash out on the street.
It's not the same as a litter of kittens.
No, I know that. That's different.
But we don't throw the kittens on the street either, do we?
No way. No way, Cocky Boo.
So we don't litter with litter. And what do we do with our garbage if we don't throw it on the street?
Put it in the trash can.
Well, the trash can get awfully full.
Then you empty it.
But then it's back on the street.
No, you don't empty it on the street, silly.
Well, I would.
You give it to the trash man. They come and they pick it up in their big trucks.
I mean, yeah. there's a trash man who has a truck?
Yeah, he comes to our house.
He comes to your house?
Yes, he does.
But I live in the park and he never comes there.
Oh.
Remember, I'm homeless. I don't have a house.
Oh, I see.
So does that mean I can litter and you can't?
No, I don't think so.
You mean, even if I live in the park and sleep on the grass, I have to keep it clean?
Yeah, you do.
Well, I can do that.
Good.
So, what's the purpose of our story? Have you got a song about litter?
I got a song about what we're doing. Yeah, I do.
Well, it would be nice if we had it.
Okay, well, let's give it a try then, okay? Reduce, recycle, and reuse. Teach the children, don't refuse. Use our tapes and have some fun. And do some good before you're done. Reuse, recycle, and reduce. Dig in, stop, ding, the earth's abuse. boys and girls can help us now if we only teach them how.
Wow! Dr. Seed, did you write that song?
I wrote that song.
And you taught it to Elwood?
We learned it together.
Now, how did it go? Tell me the words.
How did it go? Let's see. It went reduce.
Reduce.
Recycle.
Recycle.
And reuse.
And reuse.
Yeah.
And how do you teach the boys? How did that say go?
Teach the children. Don't refuse.
Teach the children. Don't refuse. Yeah. Reduce, recycle, and reuse.
You got it, Cocky-Doo. You got it.
Teach the children.
Don't refuse.
Don't refuse.
Reduce,
recycle.
And reuse.
And reuse.
You got it. You got it.
Maybe they'll all learn it. Let's sing it together.
Okay, let's sing it together.
You do the I won't.
Okay. Reduce, recycle, and reuse. Teach the children, don't refuse.
Don't refuse.
Use our take, then have some fun. And do some good before you're done.
Yay!
There's more.
More.
Reuse, recycle, and reduce. And start stopping the earth's abuse. I need a mistake, Cocky-Doo.
I don't believe you. You never make a mistake.
Everybody makes mistakes sometimes. Even Dr. C makes mistakes sometimes. Yes, he does. Everybody
does. So you
want
to do it again?
Yeah, let's try it again. Let's try it again.
Okay. Reuse, recycle, and reduce?
Yeah, okay. Reuse, recycle, and reduce. Begin stopping the earth abuse. Boys and girls can help us now if we only teach them how.
Let's do that one again.
Reuse, recycle, and reduce. Begin stopping the earth abuse. Boys and girls can help us now if we only teach them how.
Oh, wow, that's beautiful. Hi.
Hey, hi there, hi there. You're cute.
Can I give you a kiss?
Okay. Oh, like the French people on those cheeks, huh?
I'm a French puppet, and my name is Monsieur Quelquechose.
I don't know how to say that.
Quelquechose.
Oh, hi. I'm Elwood.
I wanted to say hello to you.
I wanted to say hello to you, too.
You want to teach some more things?
Sure.
I'll go in his pocket again.
Okay.
Bye.
Nice seeing you.
Shake my hand.
Wow, you shake with your mouth, huh? Uh-huh. It's not wet, though, so it's okay.
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 A tree. I'd rather be me than watch TV. I think I'll go and hug a tree.
I'd rather be me than watch TV. I think I'll go and hug a tree. I'd rather be me. I'd rather be free and live life in simplicity.
I'll go out and find some wood and carve it into something good. I'll find a rock and beat the ground and listen to its beautiful sound.
Cause I'd rather be me than watch TV. I think I'll go and hug a tree. I'd rather be me. I'd rather be free and live life in simplicity.
I'll find some water and some dirt and draw some pictures on my shirt. When my mama catches me, I'll run right out and hug a tree.
Cause I'd rather be me than watch TV. I think I'll go and hug a tree. I'd rather be me. I'd rather be free and live life in simplicity.
I'll find a bug and watch it crawl, climb it slowly up the wall. Find some things and I'll make a house and have some tea with magic in his mouth.
Cause I'd rather be free than watch TV. I think I'll go and hug a tree. I'd rather be free. I'd rather be free and live life in simplicity. I'd rather be me than watch TV. I think I'll go and hug a tree. I'd rather be me. I'd rather be free and live life in simplicity.